The name of this purely marine group of invertebrates is derived from the Greek for hedgehog skin. The group includes starfish, sea urchins, brittle stars, feather stars, and sea cucumbers. Echinoderms have radiating body parts, so most appear star-shaped, disc-shaped or spherical, and all have a skeleton of calcium carbonate plates under the skin. Inside is a unique system of water-filled canals, called the water vascular system, that enables them to move, as well as to feed and breathe. Typically bottom dwellers, they live on reefs, shores, and the seabed. The echinoderm body is based on a five-rayed symmetry similar to the petals of a flower. This is apparent in starfish, brittle stars, and urchin shells, testes. Sea urchins are like starfish, with their arms joined to form a ball. Sea cucumbers resemble elongated urchins, their five-rayed symmetry can be seen end-on. The echinoderm skeleton is made of hard calcium carbonate plates, which are fused to form a rigid shell, as in urchins, or remain separate as in starfish. Usually, it also features spiny or knob-like extensions that project from the body. Sea cucumbers have minimal skeletons reduced to a series of small, isolated plates. The water vascular system consists of a ring canal with branches to each arm or body segment, as well as blind-ending tube feet that extend out through pores in the skin. Most echinoderms have separate males and females, which reproduce by releasing sperm and eggs, respectively, into the water. Individuals often gather to spawn at the same time, thereby increasing their chance of success. This synchronized spawning is initiated by factors such as daylight length and water temperature. Each echinoderm group has its own type of larva with its own way of swimming, floating, and feeding. The larvae eventually transform into their adult form and settle on the seabed. However, some starfish keep their fertilized eggs and developing larvae in a pouch under their mouth, and nourishment comes in the form of yolk. In some brittle stars, the larvae are brooded in sacs inside the body, and the young are released after metamorphosis. In most echinoderm species, however, the fertilized eggs drift in the plankton and develop into free-floating larvae. Echinoderms range from peaceful grazers and filter feeders to voracious predators. Carnivorous species of starfish extend their stomach over their prey and digest it externally. In contrast, most sea urchins are grazers, scraping rock surfaces using teeth that resemble the chuck of an electric drill. Combined with muscles and skeletal plates, they form a complex, powerful feeding apparatus called Aristotle's lantern. Sea cucumbers have an important role as seabed cleaners, vacuuming up organic debris and mud. If they can be broken open, sea urchins make a good meal for fish, sea birds, and sea otters. So, along with many other echinoderms, they protect themselves from predators with their long, sharp spines. These spines are mounted on ball and socket joints and can move in all directions, which turns them into fearsome weapons. If an echinoderm is attacked, spines may break off and embed themselves in the predator, creating a wound. Some spines are also venomous, such as those belonging to the crown of thorn starfish. Fire urchins and flower urchins also have enlarged and venomous, pincer-like pedicellariae, which are strong enough to sting humans. The cumbersome-looking sea cucumbers have no spines or protective plates, but they are far from defenseless. If attacked, many eviscerate their gut, and sometimes other internal organs as a decoy and regrow them later. Some tropical sea cucumbers eject sticky white threads, called couverian tubules, which are strong enough to entangle and restrain an attacking crab. Brittle stars and starfish can break free from attack by discarding and regrowing arms. While the majority of starfish species have five arms, this large species has seven arms and very occasionally eight. Its body and arms have a velvety texture and are colored brick red to orange brown. Each arm is fringed with a conspicuous band of multidirectional, stiff white spines, which help the seven-armed starfish to bury itself in sediment and delve after prey. Using its long tube feet, it can also move very quickly over rocks and gravel to latch onto its victims. This starfish is a voracious predator that feeds mainly on other echinoderms, including burrowing sea urchins, sea cucumbers, and brittle stars. It breeds during the summer in southern Britain, but much earlier, between November and January, in the Mediterranean. This strikingly patterned species has long, thin arms and a flat disc. The arms and disc are edged by rows of skeletal plates that protect the starfish and give it a rigid feel. These plates may be pale or dark and they form unique patterns on each individual form, which enables researchers to recognize, track, and monitor individuals in the field. Data from such studies indicates that stars grow very slowly and largest individuals may live for several decades. Although icon stars usually live in deeper, dark waters, they are common at depths of 15 to 65 feet, 5 to 20 meters, around Singapore. Probably because the water there is turbid and light levels are low. Females produce large orange that develop into tiny orange larvae. The eggs contain chemicals that deter fish predators. The goosefoot starfish gets its name from the appearance of the flattened, web-like disc that joins each of its five short arms together and produces an almost pentagonal shape. The central dark red patch and conspicuous red lines radiate outward from this patch along its arms. Its underside is colored yellow. This starfish glides slowly over the seabed searching for small crustaceans, mollusks, and other echinoderms to eat. The incredibly bright colors of this starfish are a warning that it contains toxic chemicals. It should not be touched, as it can cause numbness. A mosaic of raised yellow ridges covers its red upper surface and it has a soft texture. The mosaic sea star feeds mostly on sponges, and these may be the source of its toxins. When the females spawn, the fertilized eggs are retained and brooded on the underside of the body. Sand dollars are sea urchins that have become extremely fattened as an adaptation for burrowing through sand. A mat of very fine spines covers the shell, or test, and the pattern of the animal's skeleton plates can often be seen through the skin. The mouth is on the underside. At the rear are two notches that open at the margins of the test, and water currents passing through these slits are thought to help to push the urchin down and prevent it being swept away. Sea lilies are stalked relatives of feather stars and usually remain fixed in the same place after developing from a settled planktonic larva. However, while Neocrinus decorus and other, similar sea lilies cannot swim in the way shallow water feather stars do, they have been filmed dragging themselves over the seabed by their arms. To do this, they appear to break off the end of the stalk, then reattach to the substratum using flexible, finger-like appendages on the stalk. In this way they can escape from predatory sea urchins. The stalk consists of a stack of disc-shaped skeleton pieces called ossicles, and looks like a vertebrate spinal column. Sea hies feed by spreading out their numerous, feathery arms against the current and trapping plankton. Food particles are passed down the arms and into the mouth. This small sea urchin has been responsible for the demise of large areas of giant kelp forest off the North American coastline. Like most sea urchins, it feeds by scraping away at seaweeds and fixed animals, and its favorite food is the giant kelp Macrocystis pyrifera. Unchecked by predators such as sea otters and California sheephead fish, numbers can reach densities of up to several hundred animals per yard too. Such large numbers can chew through kelp holdfasts, setting the plants adrift. In the past, when sea otters were hunted, urchin numbers increased explosively in some areas.